चेयर को लगा दे।
Here, ladies and gentlemen, it is the Akamai Customer Day. It's the fifth edition here in Mumbai, and wow, this is like a childhood dream just coming, you know, true to its truest form. I, you know, as a child when I was growing up, there were days when I used to dream of performing and speaking to empty chairs. So if you don't mind, can you please get up and come forward, guys? Come, get up and come forward, everyone. Please get up, guys. Come. Come, people wearing suits, people wearing like 3-4 of those badges around the neck. Gentlemen at the back as well, don't worry. We have, it's not like we're going to be giving you examination papers and all of that. Come closer, no? I mean, this suddenly feels like the population of Indore or something from Mumbai. It's supposed to be more crammed in, you know? Come in. Hi, everyone. Good evening. Have you had a good day so far, ladies and gentlemen? You could react with a yes or no, it'll really help. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, okay, let's see, more people moving in, great. Okay, so everybody from Mumbai itself, everybody from Mumbai? I'm from Bengaluru, and I really think our potholes need to come and learn from the potholes that you have. Ours are very well behaved, they're tiny, they're small, they're not lethal, but you guys, one U-turn from around the airport, how do you guys drive here? It's dangerous, man. It's very dangerous. Okay, my name is Danish Seth, ladies and gentlemen. Bengaluru boy, did the show there as well. And right through the show there, everybody from Akamai was telling me, bro, you got to come and check the crowd in Mumbai out. They're so much fun. You guys are a lot of fun indeed. Okay, just set the agenda right this evening. We're going to have a bunch of presentations. Whatever you take home from there is good. What you don't take, make sure you take it during dinner or during drinks, because we have the entire Akamai sales team here as well. Everybody who works at Akamai, please stand up very quickly. Let's welcome all our guests with a round of applause. All the Akamai employees, please stand up. Let's give our guests a big round of applause. Nice. All of them sitting right next to the door. And remember, all of them are from sales. You can't get past them. All right. So ladies and gentlemen, fifth edition. How many of you, it's your first time to this event. How many of you at this event for the first time? Wow. Okay. Like you've, in the last 5 years, this is the first time you've ever made it here. Yeah. Okay. Please stand up. All the first timers, please stand up. All the first timers, please stand up. Right, ladies and gentlemen, Akamai Customer Day. All these are the virgins. Let's give them a round of applause, everybody. Great. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have about 90 minutes. We also, that's it, sir. That's only how virgin you will be. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, we also have a bunch of awards that we're going to be giving away today. It's going to be a relaxed evening. We have a quiz that's going to come somewhere in the middle, so you also have a chance to win yourself some prizes. So shall we start, ladies and gentlemen? Yes or no?
Yes.
Little more energy, please. Shall we start? Yes or no?
Yes.
All right then, ladies and gentlemen, to formally welcome each and every person in this room, I'm going to first up bring on stage Managing Director and Vice President for Akamai Technologies India, Mr. Siddharth Malik. Let's have a round of applause, everyone. Come on. Little more. Try cheering a little bit. Come on. Suddenly feel like I'm at the Lords in England watching a test match. All right, over to sir.
Thank you, Danish. Good evening, everybody. On behalf of Akamai, I welcome you all for this customer day. I'm sure there will be a lot of meaningful dialogue throughout the evening where we will learn from each other. And I know you are business leaders of your respective companies, and you do try to keep an eye in the future to ensure that you adapt to the new trends and move your company faster forward. But I'll request you to take a minute or so to see how we can imagine the future of internet, how we can bring that focus today in terms of how the internet is going to look like and what are the challenges we are going to see and we need to overcome to ensure that we build the future of the internet the way we are imagining it today. Now, for example, imagine a world where billions of people are watching TV online and generating tens and thousands of terabytes of traffic. Today, as the research says, by 2020, there will be more people watching TV online than through the normal broadcast mechanism what we have today. Imagine a world where hundreds of millions of connected cars are engaging in billions of updates per second. And also imagine some of the sensors which are there today in various schools, various hospitals, manufacturing plants, and also in our homes today, sending enormous amounts of data to command and control system for collection, analysis, and decision making all in real time. Imagine the financial world on the internet where trillions of micropayments are getting processed and secured online. Another way of imagining the future of internet is to basically see the amount of data, the sensors which are generating, monitoring your health, and providing real-time alerts to you. And I'm very sure the future is not far off when you will see certain sensors in the golf balls and the tennis balls, which will talk to your sports gear and give you the trajectory of the ball so that you can practice against the way your favorite professional practices. So I think these are very, very realistic imaginations. But at the same time, if we talk about the future, I think the possibilities are endless. And when we talk about the possibilities, they're very easy to imagine, they're fun. But I can definitely tell you, to deliver on these very high expectations for internet to take the shape, it has to, there's a lot of hard work which needs to be done. And for the starters itself, I think the first fundamental thing which comes in my mind that if you have to imagine the future of the internet the way we have just spoken about, I think scale is going to be very, very paramount. And just to give you a glimpse about the scale in terms of Akamai platform, that will tell you what is happening actually in today's world and how the requirement will be in the future. At Akamai, we are now processing trillions of transactions every day. This year alone, we delivered roughly around 50 exabytes of data to billions of devices around the world. It takes more than 7 petabytes a day just to log all the transactions on Akamai platform. And we also manage an archive of over 300 petabytes so that we can optimize the performance and security of your web properties. Now, think about the scale we have today. It's huge. But if you're going to imagine the future, and if we have to build the infrastructure, this scale has to grow. And I'll share with you how much we need to grow it to ensure that we deliver on the promise of making the future of internet fast, reliable, and secure. Now, definitely scale is important, but if we have to build the future of internet, which is the way we have imagined, there are certain challenges which we need to overcome. As I talked about the scale, the numbers are so big that it's hard to comprehend. But as big they are, and if we are going to achieve any of the future trends, what we just talked about, we need at least 4 times the scale we have today. And it's just not about Akamai platform scale. It is about the whole internet infrastructure across the globe, which needs to grow by 4 times to ensure that whatever we have imagined comes to reality. Now, scale itself is not important. I think scale with performance and reliability at the same time is very, very critical. So the first challenge which we need to overcome to imagine the future of internet and to make it a reality is scalability and performance. The second one is about agility and control. And I think this is very critical as well, and I think this is directly coming from you. We have been doing these customer days for the last 5 years, and some of you have given us a feedback that you want us to make our services a whole lot easier to use, and we have been working very hard on that. Now, ease of use becomes very critical when we think about a system where trillions of components are generating billions of transactions. Now, on one hand, the control fabric needs to be fully automated because you can't handle that enormity of the data. At the same time, it has to be distributed to the scale. And thirdly, it should be easily managed by one human being. So that's the agility and the control we are talking about. I'll share more about it because I think that's very, very critical. Last but not the least is the security piece. You have seen the security landscape today across the globe, also in India, and it's not a very good picture we see today. And I can promise you, this is going to become more challenging in the future. Many of you would have heard about the Mirai botnet. Now, that particular attack was generated by including security surveillance cameras, the DVRs, across the globe, and it was one of the biggest attacks which Akamai has seen lately in the last couple of months. Now, this situation is going to become more brutal because people who are attacking the various assets on the infrastructure, they are very sophisticated. The kind of technology they use is very, very sophisticated. So I think if we have to put our core businesses on internet, security becomes paramount, because if we don't do that, we will not be able to bring more users onto the internet. Let's take what Akamai is doing about scalability and performance. Now, lately, what we have done in Akamai here is that we have tried to start bringing innovation across various verticals. So we have divided our company into three divisions, and the first one is the web division. And this division is focused on creating innovation by providing instant and secure access to all apps for all users everywhere on all devices. Now, when we say that this is the vision, and this is the vision which we really need to bring to fruition, we need to focus on all kinds of web traffic. We just can't say that we will be securing and giving an access to a certain kind of a traffic, because that's how the whole internet world, the ecosystem is evolving. So when we talk about all web traffic, we look at all websites, native mobile applications, APIs, images, and the user can come from any kind of a device. So whether it's a PC, whether it's a mobile phone, whether it's an IoT, IoT is a platform which is going to play a very critical role in shaping up the future of internet going forward as well. And coming from any kind of a network, whether it's a cellular, Wi-Fi, wired broadband. And so Akamai is focused on making this particular division, the vision of this particular division, a reality. There's a lot of work happening. I think in this room we have Anand Venkatraman, who heads the web division here. And I think during the course of the discussion, if you have any question around the web division, Anand, can you stand up and say, just raise your hand so that people can recognize you. So the next division, which is very critical for Akamai as well as for the ecosystem, is the web division. Now, imagine the first thing what we try to basically imagine in terms of making billions of people watch TV online. Now, this is the division which is focused on making that a reality. And the mission of this particular division is to provide the highest quality experience possible on any device securely to audience anywhere at scale. Now, there are a couple of components which are very critical to realize this vision. First is, we are talking about great entertainment experience, which needs to be immersive. How many of you watch cricket today on internet? And what's the kind of an experience you have today? Literally. Hotstar is one of our customers today, and they are doing a great stuff in terms of innovating the whole OTT platform and media delivery. And the scale we are talking there is highest bit rates possible, which gives you a very close quality of what you see on TV. And at any given point of time, more than 3 million users watching that match. Imagine the kind of a traffic they're generating, and imagine that without any latency, if you are able to broadcast that, this definitely requires a lot of innovation at the back end from a platform perspective. So this division is focused on creating a scale, because when you talk about media consumption, definitely scale is very, very critical for you guys to be profitable. And the third thing is the quality. And we are focused on giving you the highest quality with no interruption or degradation. So that is, and I think in the room we have Sid Bishwati, if he's around. He's there, who's running a media division here in India. During the course of the day, if you have any questions, any more information you require, please, definitely he'll be of assistance. Moving forward, the third division in Akamai is a very young division. And why I call this is a very young division, but the most critical one as of today, because the way enterprises are adopting internet as a part of their formal network, this is becoming a reality in a big way. And this division's vision is to secure, protect, and accelerate the enterprise service in the cloud. Now, there's a lot of innovation happening around how to provide enterprise access, how to ensure that there is a threat protection for all your enterprise applications, whether they are SaaS, cloud-based, or hybrid, or any kind of an enterprise user, whether coming from a branch or headquarters, mobile, or third-party partners, channels, so on and so forth, and across any kind of a device. Now, this particular division, and we say in Akamai that we want to try this on ourselves, because Akamai is a pretty big company from an enterprise network infrastructure perspective. We are present in more than 35 countries today, so, and we have more than 7,000 employees. So we are using this technology internally to ensure that we are protecting ourselves from all kind of attacks at the same time. It's like eating your own dog food. So we are trying to consume this technology to ensure that it is fit for a commercial consumption as well. And in fact, we were doing the same customer day in Delhi a couple of days back, and one of our customers said that I am secured from all angles, and he was an enterprise customer. And Siddhartha, I don't see any value in some of your products. I said, wonderful, we would like to learn from you how you ensured and ring-fence your whole enterprise to ensure it is secured from all angles. And within a day, their whole assets were compromised by exploiting DNS kind of a scenario in that company. And this division is focused on that. And I think we have Bruno sitting here in this room who is running this enterprise division for us here in India. Bruno, why don't you share that example, what the conversation you had with that customer, so it becomes meaningful for everybody?
Sure, Siddharth. So what happened was, I think the one thing that the customer has had, which you all have in common, they have provided internet access from their office for employees outside, right? So you have internet links and internet exit plans. Now, to enable internet, you need the components. DNS is a critical one. And what now actors have done, bad actors have become so sophisticated, they have developed techniques that enable them to use DNS exploits and bypass all of your existing on-prem security solutions that are signature-based, for you know, blacklisting-based, rate control-based. And so that's what the customer, you know, got impacted by. And it's not its fault, right? It's a new vector. People are not aware that DNS is something that is exploited. Now, what's important is the question that came up was, hey, why did all of these solutions fail? Now, the reality is, for these type of exploits, what you require is real-time detection based on machine learning and heuristics. Now, that type of intelligence and detection is as good as your data. When it comes to the internet, Akamai has all of the business traffic, right? All of you guys, and y'all are the ones that get attacked. And our platform and our recursive DNS solutions is used by all of the carriers. So we are able to provide that level of real-time detection, complementing everything that you already have in your data center. So now, what we're trying to do is educate customers that everyone cares about protecting your enterprise network, right? You don't want your data to be compromised, stolen, or corrupted. You need to have this type of solution. And that's what we mean the customer.
Good. Thank you. Thank you, Bruno. So moving forward, I want to spend a little bit of time on the agility and the control piece, I think, because that came directly from you. And I'm happy to report that we have heard your feedback and definitely can claim that our services are getting much easier for you to deploy and maintain. So there are a lot of things on this particular slide, but let me take some of them. The first one, onboarding and configuration assistant. Now, through this particular innovation, you can interact with our tools more effectively. It will enable our new customers to get provisioned on Akamai network 15 times faster than what it used to take in the past. And for our existing customer, it gives us the ability to create new delivery configuration within minutes. The second one is a very important one. We heard that from many of our customers, both here in Bombay and Delhi, and definitely across APJ, automated certificate provisioning. Through this, you can provision your certificate for secure sites without even leaving Akamai portal. And if you're a user of Akamai platform, you know what Akamai portal is all about. And now both these capabilities are up and live and available even today. And if you would like to get an access to these, please reach out to our team in this particular room. The third one was Akamai Marketplace, where you wanted us to expand the marketplace so that you can try and buy new products directly through our portal. Fast Purge was another ask from you, where you can now delete unlimited amount of content in just 5 seconds. And metadata activation is another important one, where you can deploy configuration files to the staging environment in less than 4 minutes, and definitely onto the production environment in less than 15 minutes. And a lot of innovation happening around media acceleration, media service life, where we are bringing a lot of efficiencies as well as trying to reduce the latency and so on and so forth. So there's a lot of stuff happening. So what I wanted to share with you is that we listen to you, and we are really working hard to make that happen. And all of these things are available right now. And if that was one of your asks, and it is now reality, so do let us know if you can come and share more information about the same to you. Okay, the last, before I go to the security piece, I definitely also want to share with you some of the managed services we have here in Akamai India. The first one is the Network Operation Control Center. And if you happen to be in Bangalore, please be my guest. We'll take you through our executive briefing center and share with you what all these centers, command centers, do there. The NOC center here in Bangalore for Akamai is the biggest NOC in the world, where we manage roughly around 67% of the network workload. The second one was the Security Operation Center. As you would have seen through various news and media, that the kind of an attacks what we are seeing getting generated out of India also is increasing. In fact, what we saw in the first quarter, I think there were 10 million attacks which was generated, or Indian ecosystem was impacted in some shape and form. So this team is focused on providing security to all our customers, not only in India, but across the globe. It is one of our biggest security operation center. And the third one is a broadcast operation control center. And in case of an live events, and if you want more optics, forensic, proactive knowledge of how the stream is working, if there are any problems with the quality, whether buffering is happening, this particular command center will be able to give you more on that, and in fact also the user behavior, so that you can make changes on the fly. So let's talk about security, last but not the least, because this is very, very critical. In fact, if I have to say, this is one of the most important challenges which we need to overcome to make internet fast, reliable, and secure. Scalability and performance, yes, we are working. In fact, every stakeholder in internet today is working on that. Agility and control, yes, we are making huge progress there. But security is again in an area where we, all of us, need to come together to ensure that we make this place a better world. So if I just talk about security, imagine maybe a couple of years back when some of the security researchers were warning us about attacks coming from refrigerator. And you might have found it very silly when they said that. But now when you saw the biggest attacks coming from cameras and DVRs, it doesn't sound so silly anymore. And on top of it, there are 5.5 million devices which are getting connected every day onto the internet. Now these devices are very similar to the devices which we saw in a Mirai botnet attack. Now if you just look at these cameras and DVRs, they have a very capable CPU, they have a full communication stack, and thirdly, they have access to plenty of bandwidth. Now what does that mean? That means that the DDoS attacks are going to become even larger and more frequent in the future. So if these devices are going to generate and become an agent for spreading the attack, this situation is not good, and we definitely, but on the other hand, we need these devices on the internet to achieve what we want to achieve. So I think there's a lot which needs to be done to make this place a more secure place. And with the cloud on the upswing, and cloud is in a reality today, everybody accepts that cloud is the way to go forward. Now, what does that mean? If cloud is moving forward, then the data centers are also increasingly becoming more and more aware about the issues which are related to the security. Now, these data centers are not equipped to handle the attacks what we are seeing today in the world, because they don't have enough capacity. Even the largest of the largest data centers in the world have limited capacity and can be overwhelmed by the attacks we are now seeing. And even if we are able to provide that capacity, whatever it takes to thwart those kind of an attacks, I can promise you from a cost perspective, it will become so productive that you will be out of business. So I think if attacks are reaching your data center, I can tell you, we as well as you, everybody's in trouble there. And the whole focus of Akamai is to see and ensure that can we create innovation where we make your data center invisible. Now, just to share some of the, I would say, Akamai's footprint in India, we definitely work very closely with most of the high-tech firms, most of the stock exchanges here in Mumbai, most of the media entertainment companies, and also the e-commerce firms. We are today present in every major city in India, every major network in India, you name it, and we will be present there. And we are just, 90% of our users are just one network pop away. So that's the kind of a footprint we have in India. And so I fully appreciate and agree that the core of your digital business is the internet. And you can't afford to rely on best effort network to be fast and reliable, to keep you secure and protected, and to give your customer flawless digital experience anywhere, anytime, exactly the way you envisioned it to be. And Akamai Cloud Security Delivery Platform is an enterprise class internet that elevates your businesses above the security threats, unpredictable performance, and business risk of the best effort. And I would like to close by humbly sharing with you that your business doesn't need best effort, and it needs the best. So with that, I thank you all for coming and being part of this customer day, and I'm sure there will be a lot of learnings to be taken back and implementing that in your businesses to ensure that we make internet fast, reliable, and secure. So with that, I thank you all and welcome once again.
Thank you very much, sir. All right, ladies and gentlemen, quick question. Let's talk a little bit about innovation. How important, on a scale of 1 to 10, how many of you believe that innovation is important at like number 10? How many of you believe innovation is important? Okay, let's just find out. Sir, you look like an innovative man. Judging you, I don't know. Innovation, if you had to innovate something for our country, what would it be? Hold the mic, no, my job. You tell, no answer. Hey, won't we take quiz contest award? Say something, no, anything will work. Baba, what are you looking at him, brother? Say anything. कोई तो आंसर होगा सर आपके पास इंटरेस्टिंग सर कुछ तो बोलो कुछ तो इनोवेशन करोगे आप कुछ नहीं करना है वेरी गुड सर वेरी गुड सर आपको मेरे प्रोफेशन में होना चाहिए था मेरे को ही कुछ नहीं करना है अच्छा सर व्हाट अबाउट यू सर इफ यू हैड टू इनोवेट समथिंग एनीथिंग व्हाट वुड इट बी Security, is it? What security? Outside the building kind of security or? IT security. I think you launched a new product or something, no? You did, right? You did? They have it. Buy it from them, please. And then just tell them so I get my commission. Acha, Anything besides your IT world, let's get out of there and let's discuss some fun things. So, an innovation that you think our country needs.
Something to mute the MCs.
Something to mute the MCs.
Remotely.
No, that we do, right? On television, sir, when Virat Kohli says MC, BC, we don't get to hear it in any which case. So, how about you? Anything creative? Anything innovative? Anything at all?
Money minting machine.
That I think for now exists only with the ministers. You know, today one of the ministers in Karnataka got raided. Do you guys know what happened? They found 9.5 crores in his house. I think if they put all the money that all of us have at home, we will still not have 9.5 crores, if I'm right. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, somebody said they want to, you know, make a money minting machine and keep it at home. Would you guys be interested in keeping a machine like that at home? Would it work? How about you, sir? पैसे छापने का मशीन अगर कोई बनाएगा आप घर लेके जाओगे ये भी नहीं लेके जाओगे हाँ ईमानदार आदमी हो यार ओके वेरी गुड तो आप जैसे लोगों के लिए जिनको किसी चीज़ में इंटरेस्ट नहीं है सिर्फ आईटी में एक अच्छा सा डिस्कशन है हमारे पास अभी माइक बात जब दिया तो बात नहीं किया आधा घंटा तुम्हारे सामने था एक काम करते हैं सर लेट्स गो अहेड एंड फाइंड आउट इनोवेशन फॉर द एंटरप्राइज लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन द इंडिया पर्सपेक्टिव व्हाट शुड वी डू टू टेल अस अबाउट दिस आई एम गोइंग टू इनवाइट ऑन स्टेज our partners for this event, representing them, Mr. Nitin Mishra, Senior Vice President and Chief Product Officer from Net Magic Solutions. Let's have a round of applause. Hi, sir.
So, good evening, everybody. How are the spirits? I hope you are all feeling great, although you know, it's not been raining much in Mumbai. So, I mean, as compared to its usual, so it's been less, it's a bit sunny and all. I hope that makes us all spirits high. So I think for some of you who are really wondering, right, the NTT NetMagic and Akamai, how many of you really think that it's an association which adds value? I'm sure you know both the organizations. How do you see it as a very, you know, logical marriage of two organizations or partnership between the two organizations? Can please raise your hands if you think, you know, there is a common ground or there is why these two organizations work together. Okay, so let me just explain it to you. I don't think, you know, I didn't see many hands go up. So it's pretty much like, you know, we are two sides of a coin, right? NetMagic is a large data center company. We host, you know, some of the largest websites, the servers, storages. We host data for our organization, for many enterprise organizations and Akamai really delivers that data over their cloud network to, you know, the end users. So it's really very, you know, a combination which brings a lot of value to the customers. And I think it really reflects in the fact that we were the first partner of Akamai in the country, right? Akamai is anyway very choosy and they select partners, you know, which really align with them. And I think we've been really Akamai partners for many years. So for some of you who know, I think we are now 100% owned subsidiary of NTT Communications. So NTT made a majority investment about 5 years back in NetMagic, and our partnership with Akamai even goes before that, right? So moving on, if you really look at some of the opportunities we are looking at, I mean, why the entity's engagement with us and what we really want to go to market. India is really looked at as a very exciting market because a lot of things are happening. I mean, especially as compared to Japan, from where our, you know, our parent organization really is, they see the growth in India really, you know, much bigger. And these are some of the key reasons. The economic growth, all of us hear about it. We are seeing a lot of maturing of enterprises and adoption of cloud. I think we all realize that no more, the discussion is no more about, you know, CapEx, OpEx. There's very clarity in most of the CIOs, you know, IT heads' mind as to which workloads need to go where. And obviously, a preferred way has been a cloud for, I would say, majority of workloads. The startup ecosystem has been a major booster. I think we see a lot of customers from the startup ecosystem which are really coming on board. The whole penetration of internet, you know, the mobile internet, the so many people coming on the access, that is another driving factor. All of this requires really, you know, a very high-end infrastructure at the back end as well as delivery. So that is where the opportunity for both NetMagic Akamai lies in. So we have been, as an organization, one of the other aspects, I think, has been to continuously look at newer opportunities and innovate based on the market changes. So some of those innovations I'm going to share with you all. But before that, I just want to, for people who don't know about Entity, I want to quickly give you a broad overview. So Entity is the only global organization which plays into the entire ICT stack. It has its own large networks. It has, you know, it is into mobility. It is into applications so network, application, and infrastructure. Right. So it plays across whole of it. If you look at any large IT organization, you usually find it in one of those buckets. Either it's a service provider with a telecom background, or an application integrator, or a large SI. But Entity really plays through its multiple organizations in, you know, all these areas. So Entity Data is a large application integrator. We are part of Entity Communication, which owns, you know, most of the data centers and the network, the cables, submarine cables, as well as internet traffic. Dimension Data is a system integrator organization, part of the Entity Group. So network integration, you know, erstwhile Data Graph was acquired, and, you know, that has grown. And really, that is the dimension part of it. Entity East and West are more, you know, Japan-focused organizations. So effectively, if you look at it, between this, all these organizations, we cover the entire gamut of IT services. Entity is currently ranked 50 in the Fortune rankings. So, you know, it's really been expanding. To reach there, it has really expanded outside Japan, and really made its footprint, you know, across the globe. That's where you really look at it. You know, it has presence across EMEA, APAC, Japan, Americas. 87 countries, 244 data centers. That makes it the largest data center provider in the globe. Going further, you know, network services across 196 countries. It is number one in data center business, as I just shared. Sorry for this. So top five, amongst top five in the global IP backbone. Top 10 in malign cables, and just look at the space of data center. 370,000 meter square, which is like a 3.7 million square feet of server space. That is what is managed, run by Entity globally. So coming to India, being part of such a organization with so much of infrastructure and, you know, such a global footprint, we have really expanded well in India as well. We have currently 9 data centers. 2 of them are upcoming data centers, and I would like to really share the way we have added the data centers. Every new facility that we are building is, you know, at larger scale. For example, our Chandivali facility is a 300,000 square feet facility, and as I said, there are the opportunities which are there actually driving our business. We have seen pretty much the whole 300,000 square feet of facility being sold out in a matter of, you know, 16 months. Right? So that is the kind of adoption we are seeing for the data centers in the country. We have, so apart from the core infrastructure data center, we have really focused a lot on innovative services on cloud. We are the early players to move in there. That is where our R&D team based out of Pune comes into picture. This team really has built our own orchestration layer for the whole public cloud. And I'll share some of more innovations which we believe really help customers you know, manage and interact with us smoothly. A lot of those developments are actually coming from our R&D center. Now, as part of Entity, we are a completely integrated One India organization, including Entity Communications, where we do a lot of networking and system integration service offerings. So that is where really look at, we have spread across 11 offices in the country. Right? So we have almost supporting 2,000 plus customers, and these are across all the verticals. We are pretty strong in BFSI, you know, insurance companies, a lot of banking customers. Media and entertainment is another segment which we are really doing well. If you look at in the really e-commerce and online space, pretty much you'll find you take 8 out of 10 of the top companies are with NetMagic, and we are really hosting and offering services to them. So this is what we do as service offerings to our customers. Obviously, colocation is the one of the contributes almost 30% to our whole business. But beyond that, I think we really have specialized in the hybrid cloud solutions, right? So we understand that enterprises, not all workloads can really go on one platform. Not every workload can run on a public cloud or a private cloud. It's always a mix of things. I mean, some organizations will have Oracle setup. There are a lot of manufacturing companies who need HANA, which has to go on dedicated setup. So that is where really we have leveraged our basic infrastructure, and we have really created a portfolio where we go, we understand customers' requirements, and then give a solution wherein some of the workloads will go on public cloud, the ones which we cannot go on the public cloud. So if it is very elastic web web-centric application, we put them on public cloud. We have some licensing constraint-based things or performance requirements which we put it on private cloud. And even the way we have designed our data centers, we have made the whole the basic networking in place, so it's very easy to create hybrid connects. I think just to give an example, you may have some of your virtual machines running in our public cloud grid, and you may be taking some of our shared services as well, right? So the connectivity is seamless. Pretty much, we have a software-defined network which is deployed in our data center. So you, whether you are, to connect the public cloud to your own private setup or your co-located setup in our data center or some of the shared services, all that is done in a seamless fashion. Pretty much each of these setup has to just connect to the nearest switch, and rest of it is taken care of by software-defined networking, to the VXLANs. So that is where we have really differentiated ourselves from, a lot of, cloud-based providers who, want to do a one-size-fits-all kind of solutions, right? So this is really the approach we have taken from the requirement downwards to offer solutions. To add to that, I think over and above, I think customers, we have typically found that it's not good enough to have a great infrastructure, right? The whole management and security becomes a key piece, and that is where we have invested our lot of resources. So infrastructure management services is what we've been largely recognized in the market as well as a provider really does it well. So right from network management, storage management, to newer technologies, even hyper-converged setups, Nutanix kind of technologies. So all we, if you typically find that we have skills and resources which can support pretty much very wide range of the IT infrastructure components that you may have. Even on on operating systems, right from SUSE to Red Hat, Windows, pretty much you name and we'll be able to manage them. Same, we have multiple platforms that we support on load balancers, F5, Citrix, a lot of web solutions. So that is where we really have put a lot of our focus. And we have innovated in the way that we, based on customer requirements, we can manage through a shared NOC or what we call a hybrid NOC, or even provide a dedicated NOC. So if customers have a very large setup of their own, we pretty much can create a dedicated NOC, which is just servicing the one customer, and you're focused there. While there could be other requirements where there are smaller few number of components, but multiple technologies, right? That is where it really is cost effective for customers if we deliver those services on a per device, per month kind of a model, and deliver to shared so similarly, I think another important part, security cannot be highlighted much. I think we obviously work very closely. We have both cloud-based services that we partner with Akamai, and we deliver security services. While on, as I think Siddharth just mentioned, security has moved beyond data centers. Data center security is a must, but beyond that, you really also need to have security in the cloud. So that is where we offer security services at data centers and also from the cloud in partnership with Akamai. So VAPT, SIEM, application firewall, WAFs, most of these services are delivered through our dedicated SOC, which runs 24/7. And this SOC really supports some of the really high-end customers. I think a good appliance helps you to some extent, but when the incident happens, you really need a good team which can react to the incident and get the problem resolved. So that is really we bring in as a value as our trained engineers in the SOC. And to support this, I think one of the challenges we typically see is it is not easy doing migrations. Could be a consolidation, customers traditionally legacy data centers of their own where the whole, they have built their IT infrastructure and applications. So either migrating it to another facility or migrating to a cloud brings in its own challenges, right? So we have a very focused professional support team which really does this, you know, very seamless fashion. I think we have done projects where we have consolidated multiple data centers of our customers into third party data centers, I mean our own data centers. We have helped them transform the infrastructure and move them onto a whole hybrid cloud kind of a setup, I mean using multiple tools for VM migration and things like that. So that is really the whole value we bring in from the professional services team. And this is, you know, apart from the migration, I think DR, GCP management itself is a big challenge. I think one, it is one thing to really invest into a DR site having all the infrastructure there, but you know, it's another thing to really be sure that if a disaster happens today, you know, everything will run smoothly. So that is where we have a dedicated specialized team of people who help do customers DR deals, you know, successful DR deals, and then that gives the confidence. We also work with a lot of DR automation tool providers wherein the whole process is automated. So the failover, failback is all automated, as well as one can really see on a dashboard as to if the disaster has to happen today, what is the RTO one can achieve. So that is, and the last part is really what we are going very actively in. So this is, I think I can share with you that we have a roadmap that very soon we are going to launch our SD-WAN services, software defined WAN services. I think probably we'll be the early movers in this space. So pretty much from lease lines, I think the market moved to MPLS, and I think the time has now come to really have SD-WAN and NFV as a solution for connectivity. So in addition to you know, offering MPLS and leveraging the HTTP backbone for ILD services, we are actually, you know, probably we're going to share more with you in some of the, you know, innovative SD-WAN services that we are right now planning. So continuing the discussion, if you really, you know, as I said, cloud has been a major focus. So we are the only provider in the country who has 5 grids here, right? So we have two grids in Mumbai, we have a grid in Chennai, we have a grid in Bangalore, we have a grid in Noida. So we can we offer services from all these grids. Another aspect is we offer both vertical and horizontal scalability on the cloud. Right? You obviously can scale virtual machines, you can add as your requirement grows. At the same time, we offer vertical flexibility wherein you can increase resources on an individual VM itself. So you can go from 2 to 4 to 8 GB, 16 GB of RAM on the same server, or you can, the same server, you can have multiple of them and load balance across. Our SLAs have been one of the best. We always been offering SLAs on a VM level. I think some of the large service providers actually do it on the grid level. So that is there. We are certified, security is all taken care of. I mean, all the standard PCI DSS, CSA star, and ISO certifications are already in place for the public cloud. This is, I would really say, innovation which Netmagic did. I think we launched Simply VPC last year. So this is actually meets requirements of a typical mid to large enterprise in the country, because it is exactly what I would say golden middle between a public cloud and a private cloud. So it gives you all the benefits of public cloud, but at the same time, it captures some of the constraints which you need to have on the private cloud. So here, what we do is we give you dedicated nodes, but the network and storage is shared, right? So effectively, I mean, maybe there could be many other use cases, but a typical use case we have found is SAP HANA implementation. The HANA has to be a dedicated node. So when we give you dedicated compute nodes, pretty much you dedicate one node for HANA, and you know, some other nodes you can create a virtualized environment on which you run the non-HANA SAP applications, right? But there could be many more, you know, you may have Oracle, then you need kind of mix. So this is a ready to use infrastructure. So the advantage of public cloud, which is, you know, immediate, less time to deploy, is available here, because we maintain the capacity the day you want, you know, 3 nodes, 4 nodes, we can deploy pretty much in 3 to 4 days time. So those are the advantages of public cloud that come into VPC. At the same time, you know, private cloud requirements of having dedicated resources, etc., is also bundled into it. So that is where really you get really golden middle of both of that. And on network and storage, it is scalable. Right? While compute is dedicated to you, you suddenly you have large growth into storage. I think you pretty much, just like you would have taken it on a public cloud, you can get into simply VPC infrastructure as well. And it comes with the same kind of self-service portal which you are used to on a public cloud. This is really, you know, a key innovations we did, and we really found a lot of success as the adoption of simply VPC has been really pretty good over time. So one of the things we have realized, as I said, you know, obviously we moved to the hybrid cloud because there is no one size fits all, right? So that is also we realized that customers have, you know, complexities, large organizations. Customers may not work with a single provider. I mean, you may have some of your applications, you know, even we have found some of the customers who are having most of their infrastructure, NetMagic may have something running on Azure or AWS for XYZ reasons, right? Maybe there is a PaaS or there is a machine learning thing which is available on those platforms and things like that. So what we have really done is, we have, because our approach has been to really give a solution to our customers and provide the managed services. So CMP is another innovation what we did. So this platform really gives our customers a complete visibility of their infrastructure across multiple clouds. So your Amazon virtual machines, your Azure virtual machines, your virtual machines in NetMagic, your bare metal servers hosted in NetMagic, all of that you can actually monitor and control through a single pane of glass. This is the whole cloud management platform that NetMagic has developed along with entity communications. And it gives you a single sign-on. You get into it, then you see all of your infrastructure. You can even manage it well, you can tag it well, you can tag by application, so it makes much, much easier. So it has a lot of functionalities. I may not have time to get into really details of it, but this is you know, really the way which we are looking at how the market is going to evolve. And we really want to be a partner with our customers where we give them a single pane of glass to manage their entire infrastructure wherever it is hosted. In our whole pursuit to be closer to the customers, you know, bring the automation benefits, I think we have really put a lot of time and effort to develop our MyNetMagic portal, which is really our interface with our customers. Right? So in a single pane of glass from MyNetMagic portal, customers are able to create tickets. And these tickets, you know, once the customer puts in, it directly gets allocated to engineer. So it cuts a lot of time in the validation. So there is an issue that customer logs in and the engineer starts working on it, I think we have cut the time drastically. Customers can manage their contacts on their own. And this is what, although some of these things look simple, but they, you know, we have really seen that in real experience, they make a big difference, right? At the right time, you should be able to reach right people. I mean, if your contacts are not updated because, you know, nobody in your organization wrote to NetMagic, that, you know, when the problem happens, people struggle. So managing contacts, we give customer complete flexibility. They are updating. They can tell us that if somebody is on leave during this period, you know, whom the alert should go. So on their own, it can be configured, and you know, that really makes a big difference when it comes to maintaining the uptime for customers. All monitoring data is available centrally. All billing information, you know, even ability to pay online, checking health devices, all of that is available in a single pane of glass. So coming to so this is what really, as I said, you know, we are two parts of the same coin, NetMagic and Akamai. Right? So I really showed how we can add value when it comes to hosting the infrastructure. So how we really, you know, work with Akamai. Right? So these are some of the key, you know, joint proposition that we have. One is this partnership with Akamai is global. So we are a global gold entity, and Akamai are global gold partners. We have gold partnership with Akamai. That really gives us a lot of synergy at all the levels. We can give a global price, we can bring the global pricing to India as well. So that is one part of it. Secondly, we have, as I said, the engineers, we have solution approach to our customers. So nobody's talking, you know, when we approach you, we are talking about complete solution, including infrastructure and the content delivery and the security, right? So we have people who can understand the entire gamut of things. We don't come and talk point solution to you, right? So that is where the pre-sale skills, we'll talk about hosting as well as come and really give a solution which is integrated and useful to you. Thirdly, it's a very long and proven partnership which has worked well for our customers. And lastly, it's a integrated technical support, right? So when there is a problem, we are not pointing fingers to each other, right? If you come to Netmagic, we are going to talk to Akamai if it is Akamai issue. But before that, we are going to really look at, we are going to troubleshoot where the problem is. Yeah? Is it in the servers which are hosted with us? Is it on the delivery side? And then coordinate and fix it, right? So that is where, I think that is a great value proposition where we give a integrated technical support. And how does this really help you is obviously a single point of contract for the entire gamut of services that you need. So hosting as well as delivery and security, you depend on us across the board. Secondly, great scalability. I think we have infrastructure, data centers, ability to scale. Akamai similarly is a cloud provider, they can give immense scalability. So when you work with us, pretty much scalability is guaranteed. You can scale on all the aspects on demand. We bring in the whole global relationship advantages to India in terms of the right packaging and pricing benefits that you get because of this partnership. And lastly, I think we are actually investing to support customers. So we work closely with Akamai. We are developing our skills and engineers as a whole program. So which will ensure that when you work with us, you get just working with us, you will get high-end support. So this is in a nutshell, I think, where really business partnerships comes in from. And to show that it really works in the market, there are so many customers that we have acquired on Akamai working jointly here. So you can see pretty much customers like Justa, a lot of online organizations, as well as a lot of insurance, as well as exchanges, which are there on our list. Some of the awards that we have got, President Sulaiman 2017, DCD Asia Pacific, the further validation of the fact that I've been stating. So that is what all I had to cover. So thanks for the
Thank you very much, sir. All right, ladies and gentlemen, before we move on to the next speaker, sir spoke about awards. We have some awards to give you as well. These are some basic gifts. Where are the gifts at? They're ready. Okay, great. Very simple. I'm going to be asking you a question. You answer the question. If you get it right, then the gift is yours. All right, it's a very cool pen that we're going to be giving you because CEOs, CXOs, CTOs can't buy pens. So we're giving you one right now. All right, let's start, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody who works at Akamai, or if you are in Bangalore, you already know what the questions are. So don't answer them. Let the clients answer. Clients, even if you give us wrong answers, you know we'll give you a pen because you're our clients. Right? Even more if you're a prospective client. Anybody who's not a client and is in this room, just like, understand. What's happening here, bro? Let's find out. Anybody here like that by any chance? Okay, great. So everybody's a client then. Good. Oh, one person. Great. Sir, what is your good name, sir? Nikunj. Sales guys. Meet Nikunj, sir. Nikunj, sir, meet salespeople. All right, let's move. Ladies and gentlemen, question number one. Which year did the internet officially launch in India? Who wants to go for the answer? Please put your hand up and answer the question. Now you want the mic. You just say the answer. I'll hold the mic. No, don't worry. You're a client. I'll hold the mic. Which year, sir? 90? Sir, Windows 96 was there. No? All of us used it. Somewhere before that, I think. 1998, you said? Let's see. Okay, great. Let's give him a round of applause, everybody. Come on. Let's give him a round of applause. That's the wrong answer, sir. All right. How about you, sir? Would you like to take a guess? Throw a number. Doesn't make a difference. Throw a number. 90? 90? Okay, 90. That's what we'll have tonight. A 90 and maybe a 60 after that. Yes, sir. Oh, these are very big clients. No, sir, sit. No, you're very big. You can lie down and answer. You're a client. Don't worry. Huh? Tell me, sir. What is the answer? Please sit down, sir. I'll sit lower if you want. 1990? Wow. How? You were there at that time? Right there in the moment it came in, like you were the first person to get the connection. You were in school in 95. Yes, sir. Correct. Of course. Great. That is the right answer, ladies and gentlemen. Let's have a round of applause for the gentleman here. What is your name, sir? Why do you keep standing, Baba? Sit, please. Why? Sit, you're a client. Aram, sir. You come through here. 1 second, sir. Please, sir. 1 second, sir. Just take this back. Sir, come. Put your legs up also. Come, sir. Sit down. Don't worry. Give sir a gift. Give sir also a gift. He tried. Give him one. He tried. He attempt also should get one. Great. Okay, next question, ladies and gentlemen. What rank is India in the top 10 list of target countries for web application attacks? What's the rank? Did you make this question paper or what? Dude, you really know your stuff, man. 4 is the right answer. Round of applause, everybody. You want to say something? We'll give you a pen. Don't worry. Come. But you can say, sir, what is in your heart? Please tell us. 3rd. I just told 4th is the right answer. Still want to say 3rd. No problem. Give one here, Baba. Chalo, no problem. Sir, no problem. Take, sir. But actually telling you we're 4th. But are you seeing the future? What is the deal? I don't understand. Okay. What percentage of the world's internet traffic is delivered through the Akamai network? Sir, this question is for you. You should know the answer. Prospective client. No, listen to this question. Huh? What percentage of the world's internet traffic is delivered through the Akamai network? 30%, sir. Okay, and what about the other 70%? Why aren't we in that space? Do you know the answer? Other people are... No, okay. So, I'll tell you. So, the correct answer is 25 to 30% of the world's traffic runs on Akamai. Please give him a round of applause. What is your name, sir? Huh? Krishna Pandeji. And the other 70%, the reason why we don't host them is because they're all pornographic websites. Really, what are you showing like this? Really, I'm not lying. That's written over here. Really, it's against Indian culture, Akamai's culture, every culture. Come, bring a pen, Baba. Where is it? Please, ma'am, please come, give it to sir. Well done, sir. You get a pen and do you sometimes 70% website? No chance. That's why you don't know. Oh, okay. Never too late to discover it, but just saying. And if it gets stuck, you know it doesn't run on the Akamai network, right? Okay, last question, ladies and gentlemen. How many internet interactions does Akamai deliver each day? Somebody on this side, gentlemen from this table. Throw an answer, please. Just a number, sir. Go for it. I'll repeat the question. How many internet interactions does Akamai deliver each day? Numbers, it could be 1, 2, 0.5, say something, no? 5 billion. See, that's good. How about you, sir? 3. Hey, this is the right answer. This is exactly what I have here. 3 trillion. Let's give him a round of applause, everybody. Well done. Let's give him a pen as well. Raja, focus here. Bring one more pen. Sir, try to give the answer. Bring one more. Bring one more. Okay, final question, ladies and gentlemen. As the world's largest distributed content deliver network, delivery network, how many servers does Akamai have deployed globally? How many servers do we have deployed globally? Now everyone, pen ke liye sab log kuch na kuch bol rahe. Bolo sir. 3600. Okay, great. Anybody else? 2,20,000. 1 second. Let me just see the answer. Now I'll have to come to the closest one. Huh? Who else? Anybody else who wants to try? And then we'll move on. Are you all clients, employees? What are your clients? 1 second, there are clients sitting over here. 1 second, hang on. Sir, please, sir, bataiye, sir. 150,000, yes. One. He just said the same thing, bro. I would have given it to him if it was right. What is the answer? Tell me. See, throw a number. He just said that. Throw a different number. 151,000, you say, no? Okay, I think we'll give it to the person who said 2 lakh. 20,000. One final, we're somewhere there. Anybody wants to go for a number? Sir?
Like 50,000.
Okay, great. How about you, sir?
3 lakhs.
I just said 2 lakhs. Okay, fine. So I'll tell you what, we'll give one to the gentleman there. The correct answer is 2,33,000. You said 220, which is very good, sir. And do we have more pens there? We have more clients than pens. No, it's not there. We have whoever. Now, whoever comes to you first, give it to them. All right? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, let's move on now. Thank you very much for participating. That was fun. Now, obviously, since it's customer day and the customers are here, we have to let you know about the products that we have on offer, ladies and gentlemen. And this is going to happen over the course of the next 40 minutes. Each presenter is going to be taking 10 minutes, and the topics are different. They're fun. So let's go ahead and invite on stage our first presenter. Please put your hands together for Mr. Matthew Lee, Enterprise Media Architect, Media Delivery. Round of applause, everybody. Come on.